Good afternoon, colleagues. I am glad to become a speaker on this World Congress. I am from Rostelecom. In the beginning of each presentation, we like to tell that Rostelecom is a small local telecom operator, this fixed line telephony. After that, we put this slide. So it's a joke. We are the biggest telecom operator in Russia and CIS. In 2016, to unite the expertise, Rostelecom decided to create a subsidiary related to all cloud stories. Now it's a group of companies, and each company works on specific field. Here are some counters which we can share. We have more than 10,000 of racks in our data centers. We have more than 46 square kilometers area. We have more than 2.5 million kilometers of networks. About 8 terabits MPLS capacity network, more than 10 exchange points, and more than 350 access nodes. In 2020, we are going to reach 12 racks, and many data centers is under development now. For manage this big infrastructure, this is telecom, this is compute, storage, so on, we need to find the new approach how to manage it effectively. Of course, when we're talking about network, the SDN is our solution. Oh, SDN is the next. Okay. So Rostelecom data center is the biggest service platform, and it provides services like a package of services. We can provide cloud, public cloud infrastructure as a service. We can provide security services. We can provide connectivity, of course, because we are Rostelecom. Also, we have our own cloud platform, domestic, our local cloud platform for our project. Coming back to SDN. So, for managing this big infrastructure, we have to create the united approach. We have many network vendors inside our data centers. We have many network levels. But also we have a cloud service, infrastructure as a service. For our cloud service, the SDN is a bridge between cloud and traditional services, MPLS, I mean. Using SDN capabilities, we can connect traditional service and cloud service. We can transparently connect virtual data center to existing MPLS network. And many our clients migrated from their own data center to cloud, and they didn't need to rebuild their network. They used the same channels. Also, SDN allows us to create new products, new service. There is bare metal as a server. Our clients can order not only virtual machines in our cloud. They can also choose physical servers. All these, all things needs to create this physical server is automated. Our orchestrator can create necessary operating system to set up all initial settings. And again, using SDN, this physical server connected to cloud. All these things automated, and also all life cycle. You can order additional VLANs, we call it virtual VLANs. You can order, if necessary, additional storage system. Also, the SDN inside data center allows us to provide bandwidth on demand, because in virtual network, which is VXLAN based, it was really difficult to set up any limits manually. Using SDN APIs, we get the opportunity to automate it and to use our orchestrator to manage it. And also unified overlay, reducing cost, because we can use low-cost hardware in underlay and using the same overlay. SDN allows us to connect different virtualized platforms. In our public cloud, we have VMware, we have OpenStack, we have Hyper-V-based hypervisors, Microsoft. But all of this can be connected to the single overlay network. So we started to think what new services can be deployed using virtual platform. So the next step is Telco Cloud. Telco Cloud is a dedicated hardware with all necessary layers already installed. For today, we use Telco Cloud to provide security services. In previous, all these security services was done manually. So our engineers design for each customer, each diagrams, prove it, approve, change it again, prove. But now all these security services can be ordered on our portal, and everything automated. For the first wave, we have six security services: this firewall, remote access VPN, intrusion IPS, anti-spam, WAF, and anti-DDoS. We're going to expand the count of VNFs, security VNFs, as well as security vendors. It's not a secret, today we onboarded Fortinet, Arbor, we onboarded our domestic vendors like Positive Technologies, and in future we plan to onboard another vendors. Like a cloud story, telco cloud, I mean infrastructure as a service cloud, like Amazon. And the telco cloud, we have created the cloud. We can sell it to our customers, but also we can use these resources to create our digital services. Like in public cloud, we create our portals and some our new products. We can reuse Telco Cloud to migrate our telecom services inside Telco Cloud. Of course, there must changes needs to be done, but in general, it's the same platform. We had experience to virtualize our IMS system, for example. We move it to cloud, but if we're looking in the security services, the main reason to migrate to cloud was to create tens, hundreds, thousand VNFs each day, each week, create, change, terminate. But when we migrate via IMS, we got the opportunity to expand and to decrease it again if necessary. So we have counters, we have actions which wish to be done on these counters, and we can expand and decrease it as necessary. Also, we have cloud in two data centers, and when we migrate IMS to the cloud, we create HA configuration based on geo-distributed model. So each site can handle the whole traffic of the entire platform, but we can balance between data centers. And of course, again, we connect our overlay network to traditional transport. But for now, transport is really static. We connected HDC statically once, for example, 100 gigabits, 200 terabits. But it's static. We can change it dynamically. We have to change it manually with many operations. So this is short key roadmap points of Telco Cloud. As I told before, we plan to create new applications to onboard new VNFs, to integrate it with our public services, so our clients as well as MPLS service, they can order security service from Telco Cloud. So we're going to create new accounting schemes, integrate it with another IT systems in many regions to test and to create more new CPE models. And also integration with IP MPLS backbone. It's very necessary because to speed up existing VNFs or to migrate another infrastructure, telecom VNFs like VEPC, VCGNAT, VBRAS, we need to automate the integration with transport. we need to make it more reliable because of multi-domain IP and optical network in Rostelecom, because of it's very big and it developed many years. We have many vendors, and we have to reuse our existing infrastructure. And that's why we are working on Transport SDN. This is another layer of software-defined network. So for us, Transport SDN is limited to individual domains. In some region we have one vendor, in another region we have another vendor. Each vendor have own SDN, Transport SDN controller. It works fine, but when we are talking about end-to-end service creation, when we need to create service between, for example, Kaliningrad and Vladivostok, we still have to waste much time to coordinate many departments, to coordinate many divisions. So the new theoretical approach is needed. This is how we solve this problem. On top of each SDN controller, we installed multi-rail SDN controller, which can control all existing domains. So this allows us three main things. First is automatic detection of topology and resources of optical and IP network. So when we're talking about network development, to add new hardware, to connect new sites, to connect new networks, now all topology detected automatically. The next, the main thing, I think, the automatic creation of services from end to end. We have one access point to create it. It can be like a GUI for administrator, operator, or it can API point, so our another orchestrator or OSS, BSS system can use it. And also it allows us to recover traffic more faster because of previous two things we told. So we use all these SDN layers. We're working on 5G. Because we need automate all of layers for create 5G networks, the first two steps was performed in the last 3 or 4 years. We have the SDN inside data center, we have a VNF platform, we have Transport SDN. This year we already tested three implementation of 5G in Russia. Here we can see that the first one was in St. Petersburg. No, there is no St. Petersburg. We tested 5G in Hermitage State Museum, so there was a demonstration of remote restoration of cultural monument with a VR helmet and robotic arm. In another hour in Kazan, we tested it in Innopolis Center, broadcast the football game in helmet. In VR, I mean. And in Moscow, in Skolkov Innovation Center, we test unmanned public transport. And we used all necessary, lowest response time of created 5G network. So when we're talking about automation, our orchestrator really, for now, can automate approximately 50% of all things, I mean, all levels in creating service end-to-end. And all these things will be reused while creating this 5G. That's all. I am the finished and still not many, any questions? Okay, thank you.